Hey everyone, my name is Devina and welcome to my channel Feedle House. Okay guys, so now I have some classics with me which are so great. Although they become boring at some point, but still we all love it. So this is Metamorphosis by Franz Kafka, and this is a very great book. You all can buy it. It's a very cheap one and I think you will get still great offer on this. Now this is 50 greatest short story. It has short stories written by Charles Dickens, William Wordsworth, Leo Tolstoy, Virginia Woolf, and this book is so great. It's great if you want to read stories of great writers in just one book. Go for that. Now I have this book written by Virginia Woolf, The Waves. This is one of again a great book, and Virginia Woolf is one of the prominent writers. Feminist writers, I must say, and she was a feminist, and her books always have touch of feminism in his book, in her books, and are very great to read. And they always talk about women equality, their problems, societal issues, and a great read it is. It's always a pleasure to read books which have feminist approach in them. Now I have this book by Mary Shelley. This is Frankenstein. So if you want to discover the history of 15th, 16th or 17th century, and you want to know what was the development of science, technology, humanity, religion, then you can go for this book. This is Frankenstein by Mary Shelley. Now I have my favorite classical writer, woman writer basically. So this is obviously Jane Austen, and these are her books. So the first one is The Sense of Sensibility. This is my most favorite by Austen. Second is Emma by Jane Austen again, and the third one is Pride and Prejudice. So basically these are stories around Elizabethan era, and they will give you the glimpse of the British society at the time of Queen Elizabeth. Now next I have is a book written by Charlotte Bronte. She is one of the Bronte sisters, famous. They both are very famous writers, classic writers I meant, and this book is called Jane Eyre, and another classic it is. Now I have finally William Shakespeare, and these are basically dramas written by him, his classical dramas which we all love to read and play. So the first one is obviously, it has to be Romeo and Juliet. Now I have The Tempest, great book. Then I have Othello, again by William Shakespeare. Now I have King Lear. You can all read these books, and the last one is Macbeth. So these books are very great books, I must say, and my books are falling because I have so many of them in my lap, as you can see. But still, these are my babies and I love them more than anything. So next we have, it's a thriller book written by Agatha Christie. She is the queen of mystery, as you all know, and this book will leave you at the edge of your seats. So great. Now this is a very special book. This book is called 15 Poets, and basically it has poem written by all the great poets of all the time. It has poem of Shakespeare, Spenser, John Milton, John Dryden, Pope, then Arnold, Tennyson, John Keats, William Wordsworth, and so many more. This is a great book if you're a poetry lover, all in one. Now I have a very special book. This is called Dr. Faustus by Christopher Marlowe, and these books are basically prescribed in English literature syllabus, and these books are so great. They have themes like science and technology, over ambition, supernatural powers, heaven and hell, and this book is so great that you all can read this book, and it's quite interesting one. Now I have H.G. Wells' Time Machine. It's great. It's a very great read for both youngster as well as the adults. Now I have this great book, I think one of the most important book which I forgot to put in the classics. This is Great Expectations by Charles Dickens, and even one movie is made on this. The movie is, I think, called, I forgot the name it had. Aditya Roy Kapoor and Katrina Kaif in that movie. Fitoor. Fitoor is based on this movie, on this novel by Charles Dickens, which is a Great Expectation. Now I have another Indian classic. This is Untouchable by Mulk Raj Anand. You all can read this book, and I think it is a must read for all the Indians. You will get to see what was the condition of the post-colonial India. Now, I have a book of Ruskin Bond. So, this is a very special book, very mild book. Not too loud, not too lousy, but a great read. It's all about falling in love again. And the name is also Falling in Love Again by Ruskin Bond. And this is a collection of short stories by him. Now, this book is The Alchemist. Who doesn't know this book? If you haven't read it, read it, because this book is all about what you want, what you should do, and how you should follow your dreams. Now, next I have is another Indian writer. This is 3000 Stitches by Sudha Murthy. She's such a great personality. She writes so simply, just opposite of Shashi Tharoor, I must say. And these books are great read if you are just a little bit romantic or you feel very down, then read her books. They will enlighten your mood, especially this one. This is 3000 Stitches by Sudha Murthy. Now, I have another post-colonial literature book. This is Khushwant Singh's Train to Pakistan. It is all about the partition of India and Pakistan and what was the condition at that time. And this book depicts it so beautifully that you all can read it anytime. And lastly today, I have this book, which is Sherlock Holmes. This is basically a collection of four stories and this is quite expensive, but I got it at a great price during a sale on Flipkart, and I think you will get it too at a very great price, so you all can read that book. Also, some book suggestions other than these books are, which I have kept here but I haven't picked it out, those are of Navneel Chakraborty. You can read his books like The Cheaters, Rose of Blood Red, The Stranger Trilogy, and then you have the Forever series. Those are such great thrillers that you may read them. And I don't recommend Chetan Bhagat's book because they tend to bore and are very simple, but still, if you want, you can read his book like One Indian Girl, Two States, Revolution 2020, What Young India Want, that is a non-fiction, and so many books. So I will be putting the name of the books in the description. You may check it out, and it's not in compulsion. It's not a compulsion for you to buy these books. If you're a ebook reader, that's totally fine. If you listen to audiobooks, that's totally fine. If you read paperbacks, then also totally fine. I'm not suggesting that you should buy books and spend too much money on them. You should only buy it if you are capable of buying them and if you will really read them. Don't just buy to put them on your bookshelf and show off. Just don't do that. It's totally the wrong ethic values. So buy it because you want to, you love to, and you have to read it. And I buy books because I can't be without reading. So that's the reason I buy the books. And so I also request to all the readers, to all the youngsters, that don't develop the tendency of buying and showing off. Just keep it to yourself and read it. And even if you're showing off your collections, make sure to read it. Just don't be like a guy who buys the books and doesn't read it and keep them away. So that's totally wrong. And that's all about my book suggestions video. If you want anything to be added, you can recommend me. If you want to review my videos, you may also do that, because I'm just a beginner to this YouTube platform. Also, if you would like to be, if you like any book to be reviewed, you can let me know. You can mail me. You can contact me on my Insta ID, which I'll be putting in the description below. I will also be mentioning all the books and their writers in the description below, so you don't need to worry. And thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Also, comment below if you want to say anything, and press the bell icon to receive freshly brewed content from me. So that's it. Bye bye, take care, and stay safe.